Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Gavinsky's Tutorials. Today I'm looking at BounceBud by Cem Olcay, and I've got 5 copies of any Cem Olcay app to give away to my followers on YouTube, Insta, Twitter, and Threads. Details are in the pinned comment at the top of the YouTube comment section, as usual. Winners will be announced in 2 days. So this is a really cool little app. Now there are other apps like this around, and I've got a few of them here. And I'm not going to make this video long. I've done several really long videos this week, so I'm not going to go into any kind of comparison, but just to mention that we've got some apps like these. These two come as part of the Rozeta Suite, which I've made 2 videos on. Highly recommend that. Now, I love these kind of little physics-based MIDI apps. And this one has some nice features. So let's first of all turn up a few more of these instances. So here I've got Phase Monkey, 2 instances, and processing these with some effects. Murph from the Moger Fogers, the Phaser, Trupan. Over here, Thump 1, which is the synth that I most recently made a deep video on. This is doing extremely well. Moger Fogger Delay there. Another Trupan. Frequenz, don't know about the pronunciation there, by Eric Sigt. Never even know if I'm pronouncing that name right. So, what BounceBud is doing here basically is we have a control here for the number of balls. So these balls get generated, then they get sent out, and they hit walls, and so we can control the number of balls. And also, resizing is going to make a big difference because, just as it would be in a real physical space, when we make this space smaller, then the balls are going to hit the walls more often. Right? So that's actually quite a lot of fun to play around with. Now the interface, you can get it pretty small. This resizes really nicely in general. So we can also control the ball speed here, and we can control the size of the balls. And let's take a look here. So here we can set up patterns, and go into the settings menu by clicking on this little cog here. Let me just reduce the ball count a little bit, maybe. Okay, so we'll not look at things in order here, look at the most important things first. So here we basically set a global scale, and I'm just going to turn off the sound a bit. So we've got a global scale setting, loads of different scales. And yeah, I'm really happy to see this. Look, there's a search bar now. So thanks a lot, Cem. I did ask a while ago. I really wish there was a search bar here because it's a pain in the ass trying to remember where things are. So yeah, search bars there, great. So that sets a global scale. And let me make this full screen. Down here, you can see that we have settings for each keyboard. Okay, so these are the keyboards on the walls. So we've got the top keyboard, bottom, left and right. And so here are the settings for the top keyboard. Here's for the bottom keyboard, the left one, the right one. So you can see that this one, I've set the note length at one bar, and the other ones are all set to a quarter note. Now for each one, we can set a different minimum and maximum octave. So, you know, this is definitely a more complex app than Rosetta Particles, for example. Here we set the minimum velocity, again, for that particular wall, right? The velocity range, so we can set the minimum and maximum range of velocity when balls hit the wall. Set here the MIDI out channel, MIDI in channel. And this is pretty cool. So select notes. So here we see all the notes in that key and scale within the range of octaves that we have allowed. And then we can go in and just untick a note if we don't want it to play that note on that particular wall, or tick to add. So that's cool, right? So for example, you could also set up just a chromatic scale, and then you could completely custom tweak the notes that every different keyboard would play, and you'd have all 12 notes in every octave to set that up with. So that's pretty cool. So yeah, so all of these things, right, note lengths and all these different settings and the notes that are selected, those can be varied for each of the four keyboards. And then we can also turn on this collision with other balls. So let's have a little listen to that. Let's put more balls. I think we're going to get a collision. Okay, so you see that also... the balls collide, but they don't actually make sound. But it'll make them change their direction and bring in more randomness. Up here, this patterns, CC number, and MIDI channel, that is just if you want to use, for example, an LFO or something like that to cycle through the patterns here. So basically create something like a song mode. So yeah, you just add patterns here, and if you long press on a number, you can copy a pattern, you can delete a pattern. Now, back in the settings menu, we can change the knob control style. I like it horizontal and vertical. By default, I think it comes as rotary, and I really hate rotary knobs. Okay, look, you've got this color theme here. Okay, unfortunately, you've got to actually stop it before you see those colors. But that's nice, right? Everybody loves a bit of color customization. Rainbow, I guess. Well, there's only four colors anyway. I don't know. Okay, yeah. So yeah, here we can also set a certain amount of randomness for the sizes of balls and their speed. And that's pretty much it, you know. You click on that tutorial button, it'll bring you into the standalone app. And then you can follow through that. Now, I had already opened it earlier, so let me go in again. Click tutorial. And it'll just walk you through all the main features of the app. So I'll just see if there's anything... Oh yeah, anything important that I missed. So one thing, make sure you press the play button if you want it to make noise. It has this feature here. Look, keyboards can shoot walls with MIDI input. It adds extra randomness. Each keyboard has a MIDI input channel. Just send a note from your MIDI keyboard or a sequencer app to that channel and make sure the keyboard has that note as well. Haven't experimented with that. It's been a really busy week. Okay, here it mentions the patterns, yes. So of course you can just manually switch between those patterns as well. And then here are these controls. So yeah, I like the fact that the speed, you know, there's no quantization for it or anything. So it's kind of nice for ambient and stuff like that. At least I don't think it's quantized. I mean, I don't know what these numbers represent. That information could be in the manual, really. Doesn't say anything about it. Okay, so you get the idea there. As I said at the beginning, I'm going to make this a really short one. But cool little app. I love these kind of things. Let's just change the scale. Well, this is one criticism I would have, and I say this about all of the Jam apps. Personally, I really hate that the scaling key is buried away in the settings menu. To me, that is a performance control, and for example, it would be great if that was just here, okay? If you could pick the scales and keys here without needing to dive into a settings menu. But apart from that, I don't really have any criticisms of it. It doesn't have any inbuilt preset system or anything like that, but you can always use your host app's internal preset system. But yeah, I mean, preset systems are always welcome, but in this kind of app, it's not personally for me a big deal. All right, so cool little app. Hope you enjoyed the video, and good luck with the giveaway. And if you haven't yet, yeah, check out those recent videos. Thump One, brilliant. Phase Monkey and Blipbox, also love them. Another video I did a few days ago, Igor Vasiliev's No Input Mixer. Absolutely love it. It is really one of my favorite apps of the year so far. So if you haven't watched that, go and check it out. All right, everyone, take it easy, and I'll see you soon. Cheers.